let's start. I'm going to...
Why don't you introduce yourself so I don't have to introduce you for...
I'm Ioannis Papadokaris. I work for the University of Thessaly. I'm an urban planner. And first of all, I want to...
His name is Kostas.
Apologize.
My name is Kostas. Kostas is his senior.
My professor, I think I'm first of all, I want to apologize because he had to be in Volos for the external evaluation of the Department of Urban and Regional Planning in Volos, in the university. And he had to do two presentations for today and tomorrow, so he probably will be here on Thursday morning. And let's start from for the Mare Nostrum project. We are the coordinators of the Work Package 5, and my presentation is going to be with two sections. The first section has to do with the Work Package 5 progress so far. Simon started something earlier today, what we did for the Work Package 5 so far. I will go through what we started already. The Work Package 5 is for producing a second report for the local knowledge coming from local case studies and local partners of the project. That means that we need to identify a baseline from these local case studies and also a common denominator and assess all the case studies in order to produce material for Work Package 7, which is the toolkit, and Work Package 6, which is the GIS instrument, something to help on the way. So, so far, as I said to Simon in the morning, the only thing that is complete and delivered is that which is assigned to Activity 2, which is the summary of the workshop in Volos. It's already done and it's finished. And let's go for the second deliverable, which has to do with the local case studies database. As you remember, we had to we had to first identify the case study and the case study area, see what kind of data is available, design some templates in order to have comparable data from each case study, and from that part we're supposed to create an inventory of relevant conditions at local study sites. This data from this inventory will pass on to Work Package 6, and Anna is not here right now, but we were talking with Anna in order to create something of a first database, an initial database, something like an ID of the case studies in order to be the first profile that someone has when someone goes to the maps of the PTGIS in order to, let's say, identify his case study in our case studies of the project. So far, the activities assigned was to create these three templates for collecting data and create an inventory. So far the templates are designed and all the partners have sent back the contribution. And the activity was to organize all data in a digital format. The inventory exists, I will show it to you later. And but the format is, the formatting of the data is missing. I was expecting Anna to, let's say, coordinate this part of the activity. We can find a formula, a format that she can use later on in the PPGIS and include this data to the PPGIS. That's why the deliverable is still pending. As for the activity 4, there's also another issue, that's the local study visits in the 5 local sites of the case studies. The last time that we were in Volos, we decided on creating just one page of feedback of someone that goes to another case study area. Let's say, until now, that's why I wrote 3 out of 4, because until now there's Rahel Kanounis's study visits in Kavala and Alexandroupolis last year, before coming to Volos. And Valencia recently, that's the fourth that's missing. And the other one, if I'm not mistaken, is Kostas with Ziva now in Haifa.
So, in the case study area.
And also I don't know if Menelaos can provide something about Valencia. I don't know if Pablo, if you met with Pablo, if you were in the same project, or you can provide something. But the whole meaning is to just send us just a page of whatever a summary of your visit in the case study area. And I think that what Rachel wants to say now is that this part of the activity will be completed in 1 year from now, when we are going to make all the...
I want to say something else. It's not obligatory. It's
no.
Maybe obligatory. What? It's not obligatory.
Yeah, it's not obligatory.
It's like a proposal, maybe obligatory. It doesn't say you have to do this. So it's pretty flexible.
Yeah, but after this morning, Simon told us that if it's written inside, we have to deliver it. So
it's also very good.
Yeah, it's the more easiest way to produce a summary of each visit from one case study department to another. So I will ask of Rahel to send me when she and she can a summary of the visit to Valencia. So this deliverable is still pending. And let's go to the data collection. And more specifically to the opinion survey. We also designed a questionnaire with the help of Technion and other partners for an opinion survey about ICTM issues in each case study area. All the opinion surveys are completed, even the last one, which Pablo and Sarah has already in their hands, but they need to translate. If I'm not mistaken, you can correct me. And this opinion survey will be the first part of the second opinion survey that will be repeated in Work Packet 7 after 1 year. In order to produce the third report. This opinion survey was made in order to get a clearer view of local knowledge and make more easily a common denominator for the case studies. And the survey, I just wrote that until now it's the templates are ready and all the opinion surveys are completed. And let's go to the final output, which is the second report. By identifying a common denominator, the baseline for all these data and all these case studies. I won't stay at this point, but I will go at this. It was the assignment of activity 5, which is analyze the existing instruments dedicated to or related to ICSM. That's already been done by each partner in their local case study reports. Identify impediments to full implementation, that's already been in their reports. Identify the gaps between local instruments and practices in ICSM. That's also in policy gaps identified. And the identification of the common denominator, which is in the real process now of identifying the common denominator. That's the meaning of this presentation and this workshop. And the writing, the production of a similar report, which is also pending I count 5 out of 6, it's 5 and then 5.8 out of 6. It's already a part of the 6th case study is ready. It's missing only a little part that's missing. The final deliverable is the summary of the conference here in Luxembourg, which we produced after the end of the conference. Also, Danny was talking about the communication. It's in relation with Web Packets 2. Also, as is going to be done for the first report, it's going to be done for the second report. We need to identify networks, as Danny said, and use all meetings from now on to disseminate first and second report from now on. And maybe, I don't know, try to capitalize into other projects. Pablo already did some work on that with another project that he's part on. And that was the assignment of Activity 9, which was to hold web-based and mass media activities in order to promote and disseminate the second report. That's also crazy. But when the report is ready, we will upload it to the website, and that will be the first of these web-based activities. Any questions so far concerning the progress of the Web Packets 5? In order to continue. No, is everything clear? Michael? Is everything clear? Is everything clear?
I'm waiting.
Okay. So, you have to forgive me because I was expecting from the agenda to my presentation to come after the case study reports, and when I saw that I'm presenting first, I tried to make synopsis of it, of the case study, in order for my common denominator to have been in practice. So, let's start from the Alexandropoulos. Whenever you see a mistake or something that I got wrong, please correct me. I will do all the questions tomorrow when you will present your case studies. So, the lethal constructions in the protected zone of River Evros Delta in Alexandropolis. We try to create a topology of each case study, and if I'm not mistaken, the topologies are three. It's national parks, or part of national parks, urban neighborhoods, and urban coastal neighborhoods, and one port. I mean the case studies, the case study areas, not the whole municipal or regional coastline. So at this case study, the Alexandropoulos, we have a national park, the specific case was started because there was a legal dispute between local authorities and stakeholders on environmental preservation versus preserving labor activities and border safeguarding. As for the local legislation, there's no laws on local level, but there is laws on national parks.
You're talking about international law, right?
Yeah, the national
law. Okay,
yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Not everybody can.
Correct. Correct. Recent term report. And the laws are mainly in national level, laws for national parks and special planning, which allow no intervention or constructions at the area of the national park. So these huts should be demolished, but the huts are still there. As for control enforcement tools, there is the general urban plan, which is a legally binding document, which is to be updated. Am I right? Okay. And the regional spatial plan, it's more guidelines. The environmental assessment studies, which been shared by the Committee of Urban and Architectural Control and Naples Delta Management Body. Some fines which are never paid, which you talked about this in your presentation, that there's too many citations and fines, but it's already not paid for any case. And there was also a coastal zone project funded by the Regional Operation Program, which was never implemented. What you see here is all of them are taken from the case study reports. As for public participation, public consultation is obligatory for plans like the general urban plan, the town plan, the environmental impact assessment studies, and the municipality action plan. But in practice, there is no substantial active participation of the local population, unless there is something of their interest in the plan that they want to go to a court or to a committee in order to complain. As for the cross-border cooperation, which is the Axelopoulos case, is one of the cases of the cross-border cooperation. It's applied only to the risk of arising from the floods and river levels, and it has to do with the three countries, Greece, Bulgaria, and Turkey. But it's not, as I know, extended to other issues and coastal issues. And the identifying, the partner identified this impediment to implementation, which is none of the central public local public bodies has excessive competence with the coastal zone area, poor application of laws, incapability issues of key staff and relevant administrative board, administration bodies, lack of cooperation between local and central authorities, little familiarity with the concept of ICC level, lack of specific binding legal framework on coastal areas. That impediments come from the opinion survey and the conclusions of the legal institutional framework in the case study.
Not
this.
Not from the surveys?
From the surveys and the local reports.
Surveys with stakeholders.
Yeah. The case of Kavala, I don't want to stay too much on that because Yorgos has said enough things before. I just want to show you the real-time photo of the area. That's the area.
This area.
And it's an urban neighborhood, a coastal urban neighborhood. It was started because several disputes was made about from property owners on the exact definition of the base of the baseline for the setback line. And the local legislation is also here, the same as in Amsterdam, more or less, the laws in urban spatial planning. But as Jorgo said, there is a lack of a clear and scientific way to define the coastline. And the control and enforcement tools are also here, the general urban plan of the city and national spatial plan, the regional spatial plan and the town plans. As for public participation, nothing different. The only different thing is that Kavala municipality has an e-government portal and platform for citizens about consultation and participation in the consultation for the general urban plan or the plans produced by the city for urban and spatial plan. And there's no cross-border cooperation with the project. The impediments identified was a more or less the same number of central and public, local public bodies as a person compensation to the local coastal zone area, poor application of laws, availability issues of key staff, local lack of cooperation between local and central authorities, little familiarity with the concept of ICT system except from fisheries research institutes located in the area, and lack of specific binding legal framework on coastal areas.
Is that his personal reference to Georges?
No. I think that the university is in Xanthi. Yes. It's not a lot of
the fisheries research.
It's a different organization, but they are very close.
Okay.
But back tomorrow, one researcher from research tomorrow, Thursday, who is a member also of Marinos TV from the Monmouth University, will come to give a talk, a presentation of the research.
If you would like to find it.
So let's go to Haifa.
It's the Baghdad in the south and coastline of the city of Haifa. And it's all renewal. I didn't know if it's a renewal project or a regeneration project.
It's not
the,
it's needle.
It's needle.
Yeah, because this is not our project. In Bat Galim, in the coastline neighborhoods, there is a renewal project. But our case study is not a renewal project. This is my project. You didn't understand it.
Okay. I will ask for it.
There is no demolition and replacement.
Okay.
It's not an architectural project anymore.
Okay. So it's my bad, and I will ask for it tomorrow. So if you can correct me now whenever you want. I think it's an urban coastal paper, the topology of the area. Yeah. And the reason why you picked up this case study was the limited access, or
yes,
not?
Yes.
Was the limited access to the coastline? And the local legislation. There are coastal planning and land laws, if I'm not mistaken, in national level. But in local, there is the Haifa bylaws, which are not so outdated. If I take the correct words out of the text. And they don't really deal with coastal issues directly.
Nice word.
Control and enforcement tools. There's a committee for protection of the coastal environment. I think there's the committee which everyone knows for a complaint on permits.
It's national
committee.
It's national.
Okay, that we crossed out. And
it's also the outlines.
The outline, yeah, but the outline plan. It's a district.
It's a district.
It's a district. It's not the outline. It's not the north. It's the district. I try to get clarity.
Now this is, I'm sorry, this is the local, well, the district outline thing is okay, this is Tamam. Okay.
If it's a Tamam, it's okay.
the district outline, the city plan.
The local level. Yes.
Yeah, the local level. And some citations from the enforcers concerning of the municipal part. But as I read, local authority is law grants inspectors of local authorities enforcement powers on issues covered by the law and in issues not covered by bylaws. But Haifa Municipality does not yet have authorized inspectors yet. Is that something that changed?
No.
No. Okay. So, as public participation, goes the approval process for the national outline plan requires public notification, and this enables minor public participation. But I feel that the public participation also is something in a minor level.
In a local too.
The local. Okay. As cross-border cooperation,
except for NGOs,
yeah. I mean from the part of the administration. For cross-border cooperation,
of course.
I can't say anything. There is some cooperation on the level of different port cities in the Mediterranean. But not on coastal issues.
It's a cultural issue.
Cultural and
sport. Sporting cultural issues.
The impediments. you can also correct me here. Urban planning approach is segmented, as I said, lack of comprehensive planning for application of laws, lack of cooperation between local and central authorities, lack of specific binding local legal framework for coastal areas, and not enough.
We have a plethora of binding laws.
Local? Or national?
Also local.
Also local? Okay.
Well, anyway, you get the point, but you will do that.
Yeah, yeah. See, okay. We will do it later, but somehow.
Yeah, and I will ask you. And I will ask you tomorrow what about these questions, now that you understand. Yeah. And I don't know about the last, not enough human, someone stated that there's not enough human resources.
Okay. It's very always, it's always.
Thanks a lot, Yannis.
Ovation from the Israelis.
I try to keep a small knife, not the
knife. Yannis got a report, half in English and half in Hebrew. I'm really proud of you.
No poisonous arrows, yeah?
So, Anna is not here to help me out for this, so I will say whatever I want, and I will show the presentation to Anna tomorrow. It's in the Grand Harbor area, and the case study is an urban port, which is, I mean, Haifa is also a port, but the case study area is outside the port. So the actual port is urban port. It started because the area has great significant, historical significance for the Maltese people, but it's also high density conurbation, plus they have too many pressures on the tourism and industry. And some evidence of gentrification, if you know, probably most of you know what is the term of gentrification.
Where
is the term? The term of gentrification.
Gentrification.
Yes. As for the legal legislation, the local legislation, there was the Development Planning Act in 92 and then the Environment and Development Act in, Planning Act in 2010. But I think that the major problem with national, Malta is not a great country in order to have local and national region. But I think that the major problem is that it's a discretionary planning system, and it's flexible, it's not no obligation for going with the law, so it's more political, let's say. And the control of our enforcement tools, I think that they have the most tools from everybody in the case studies I wrote so far. They have, except for the two authorities, which is the Malta Environmental Planning Authority, which is national, obviously, and the Tourism Authority, they have a structural plan, a strategic plan for environment, environment and development, local plans, subject plans, environment and development briefs, and action and or management plans, which is, let's say, as a strategic plans, like city plans, and then like subject plans, which is for specific subjects or for specific developments. Let's say you want to recreate that monstrous hotel you have in Haifa. They have to produce a subject plan and maybe an environmental development brief for it. So they go down locally, 11, 11, 11, and they go to the specific, let's say, 3,000 square meters that the development wanna be, and they produce a plan for that part. But I'm not totally sure because Anna is not here to help.
Are we going to have
this
presented?
Yeah.
Anna or,
yeah, I think that Anna will present the case study. So she's gonna tell us tomorrow about it. As for public participation, for the structural plan, it highlights the importance of an active role of the media, NGOs, local councils, official bodies, as well as securing and safeguarding the access to information. But, as in every case, the applicability of certain legal provisions has led to conflicts over the level of public involvement, the public consultations, and the assessment of development applications. So, more or less, we have the same picture as the other case studies. And there's no cross-border cooperation for coastal zone management issues. The impediments, lack of specific binding legal framework on coastal areas.
No marine economic zone?
They have an economic zone, I think. Yeah, also.
But
also,
I think, is the only passage
that's ratified. Yeah, Malta and Spain. Spain is the only. As I said, impediments are lack of specific binding legal framework here too, fragmented responsibilities and lack of provision in dealing with issues arising in the area, little familiarity with the ICC issues, except for the NGOs one. It's collision. Yeah. My mistake. The privatization of the coastal land, local councils lack an ability to effect simple changes within the localities, the political part, as I said, of their planning system, and very little communication between the community and the local councils. So, Pablo will help me with this. If something's wrong in it, please tell me. Yalmufera, which is also a national park. Or part of a national park?
Regional
park. Okay. It started because of the environmental characteristics of the area and also because there is in close proximity with the city of Valencia. With the local legislation, let's go to the local legislation. The national laws for as the second and the fourth, the second in 2013, the fourth in 2004, I think that's the two major legal documents for the area, nationally.
The third one is national, the one is
regional. Okay. And also there are municipal bylaws on the use of Valencia beaches and adjacent areas, which is something that's local. Okay. And also for the control and enforcement tools, there are the Valencia Regional Territorial Strategy, the Natural Resources Management Plan, the Master Plan for the park, and Valencia Urban Development Plan, which includes the area. For the public participation, the body that governs the park is a consultative body. Collaborative, participatory, and advisory. The Territorial and Landscape Participation Boards act as a direct channel for public intervention. It is obliged to organize public participation procedures for planning and projects. However, as Pablo wrote in his report, there's a lack of a tradition for public participation processes in the area. There's no mechanism or channels for public participation specifically oriented towards the great process of management in the state. And there's no cross-border cooperation case as well. And the impediments, lack of sufficient resources to ensure adequate implementation of plans, lack of appropriate tools such as territorial plans. I don't know if it's right, I don't know if. I think it's in the local level more than in national or regional level. Lack of multi-sectoral planning instruments, insufficient coordination between different administrations, and little familiarity with issues on ICC in Europe. If this last part is right, it's controversial to the ratification of the report.
Not really.
Okay. Okay. Is there anything wrong? No. Okay. And the Alicante Bay. Which was the only, because I didn't went to Valencia yet, I was in Haifa, I saw some things even through the bus, but it was the only case study that I was going through the Google Earth to see. It was very interesting. Pablo will tell us about it tomorrow, but let's go in a quick way. It is an urban coastal neighborhood. It's a case of study because it's a complex concentration of different land uses and pressures for of tourism and urban expansion, if not mistaken. For the local legislation, basically, I think that these two laws, the national laws, the second of 2013 and the fourth of 2004, are mainly here the main national laws that control the situation. And also there is, I think it's almost a regional law, the 7th of 1985, which regulates the rules of local government and gives... It's a local law?
No. It's a national law.
It's a national law too.
Regulate the role
of municipalities. Yeah. Okay. And the enforcement tools is the territorial strategy for Valencia once more. The Alicante General Municipal Urban Development Plan, which is also not binding and not yet approved.
It's binding.
It's binding? Okay. That's my bad. And the some ordinances for the ordinance for beasts and cows and municipal and general protocol on integrating actions in the North Bay of the municipality of Alicante, which is the part of the Alicante region. For the public participation, it's more or less the same as in the Alfeld Park. And the impediments here ignore the appropriate tools such as territorial plans, lack of multi-sectoral planning instruments, insufficient coordination between different administrations, delayed delimitation of posts. After the developments at the bay, and different aspects of coastal areas and problems and their solution between administration and citizens, and infrastructure-oriented planning and urban development. So, that's all about the case study areas, and let's go to first attempt to find a common denominator. And let's, that's more or less what we figure out, the 9 points, the 9 weak factors for all the case studies. And if you feel that something of the 9 of these points are not applicable for your case study, please tell me to cross it off. Poor application of laws, lack of binding legal framework indicating coastal areas, I don't know, help you said about Israel. It's not the case that
they're all what I call classics. One doesn't need to do these case studies in order to come up with these.
Yeah.
These are endemic, some of them are endemic to public administration, and all endemic or near endemic.
It is something also produced reading the reports.
All are typical of conflicts on the coast. So I would say that, you know, that's not the level we need to be in, and so that's criticism of you.
Yeah,
no, that is that we look at the very detailed factors.
Okay.
And
so,
by the way, some of them, let's see, for example, like lack of binding legal framework, from the extensive research on planning the law, sometimes binding is not better than flexible. So, I wasn't doing this. I think you did an excellent preview of the case studies, and that's the conclusions of the case studies that seem to be supported in depth, specific to the context, with then, from the context, some generalization. That's, I think we need to clap hands.
It's like the first reading. Let's keep it that way. The first reading of the reports, and then we go in depth after we discuss.
Right, and also, of course, number 8, public participation. Same point.
The public does not have to agree with us. Public participation is like freedom of speech, you know? So it's not necessarily a recipe for support. It could be, or it could not be. So, yeah, public participation is a merit on its own.
That's a big factor.
Yeah, it's a weak factor.
It's not enough.
It's a weak factor.
Yeah, but it could also be lack of public participation could be a strong factor. Governments often like to, for good goals, to bypass them. Anyhow, that's too generic.
And the strong factors, let's say the strong factors of it. It's the acknowledgement of European and Mediterranean identity for each case study. It's recognized small size and the coast, the small size and the high importance of the coasts. Coastal areas legally recognized as public property, utilizing and strengthening existing territorial planning and management institutions of flows and aquifers, etc. It's something that is comparable, something comparable from the reports. It's nothing that we produced before reading the reports. We have to read first the reports in order to come in some point of a baseline. And then we can go in depth or maybe cross something off or include something that we missed and then go deeper and deeper.
No, I'm saying, but these are interesting. These are not common. I mean, you actually found that there is utilizing and strengthening, this is number four, existing territorial planning and management institutions for ICCM. Yeah, that's very important. That's shared by...
I won't stay on that. I will go to the other slide, which is the continuation of the game.
And she also wanted some good news.
I can give it to you.
Can you explain the first one?
Yeah.
I think that also a strong factor is that they all feel that they belong to a specific area, the Mediterranean area, and the European area, even if it's...
I bet you that didn't come to
it's right. That's what I'm saying, it's not we would love to, it's a good news.
No.
We would love to be European.
No, no, the Mediterranean, so maybe I should put or there, not and.
But Israel's not that big,
yeah.
Mediterranean.
Yeah, maybe I can put or there, not
so
and.
And I really question what is Mediterranean.
I think that you can't say no to the Mediterranean.
I know.
So, this is a part of the game we started playing after in Volos that Rachel initiated with indicators. And Rachel left the document in my computer and I took it. Try to take it to another level. I don't know if it's a proposal that's not fixed. That's thoughts that have been shared from the partners of the Mare Nostrum. It's different indicators for measure ICCM implementation. If you want, we're gonna go to each one of them. And you can tell me if you find them interesting, if you find them correct or not. It's the number of planning instruments added from the start of the project locally.
This is very, very important. I think we need some preamble, some music or something. But how do you want to put this in context? This is supposed to be for which workshop or which work package?
My opinion is for work practice 4 and 5 together. But Rachel, Rachel started it in Volos for the national level of legal and institutional. Let's say I tried to get it locally.
I want to add that it's one of the main outputs of the
Yes, exactly.
It's the main opportunity.
Exactly. The reason I wanted some drama here, as you know, some trumpets, is that when the EU looks at what we deliver, indicators like those are very, these are very important. Anything that's concrete and measurable or visible. So each one of these, if you think now that you've matured with it, go ahead, now, you know, dwell on each one of these. Stop for a minute. Okay.
So, I put the words more better or less, more is better or less is better after the indicator, because I don't know if it's really, as you said before, let's say like public participation is better or worse for ICSDM implementation. So, the first one is about the number of planning instruments. Now, in each case, each partner has a certain amount of planning instruments. Some of us have three or four locally, and some of us have eight or nine. And the first thing that came to us was to count these instruments from the beginning of our project to the end of it, and if someone includes something more or transfers experience from one partner to another and make a proposal to include an instrument or a plan inside from one case study to another, maybe that's a perfect way to measure something in through my nostril.
Is it time to call? I think this is very interesting, and it's kind of things that we need to make more sophisticated. For example, they might need to be discrete, they might need to not overlap, not over-centralize, but it's a good point to start aiming our thinking and to turn thinking into much more fine-tuned. Next.
The next one is the number of days needed to reach decision in planning procedures, including public participation. So as you said, if public participation is a bad thing in some cases, or a reason for delaying, that's, I think that the lesser are the days to reach a decision, so the better is the way to go for an implementation plan or a planning procedure. I don't know if it's better for Israel or worse for Greece.
No, it's an important point because, from any country research and another project, all governments, almost all, complain about length of time, regardless of how slow or fast it was relative to the others. So yes, and you put well that includes public participation. So it's not an expense of
something that makes a difference.
Yes, very good.
The percentage of coastlines actually demarked, which is the main problem here. I don't know if I can say anything about it more. The fourth is the number of local departments working on ICSDM issues, and it has to do with improvement of the coordination and procedures administratively. The overlapping that you said from each department.
The more the better, on the other hand, with the coordination.
The number of municipal and regional decisions about coastal zones, but also that is an indicator that agro-border borders. The more complaints you have in a municipal council about coastal issues, it means that you have more problems and your planning system is not working as you expect it to. Probably.
Well, that depends on what the decisions. Okay, anyhow, that's interesting, let's circle the word decisions here, because what you now said, you mean decisions about appeals.
Yeah.
But it doesn't say so.
Yeah.
Decisions are also approval of plan.
Yeah.
It's just broad.
I think that is broader,
you mean
because...
court decisions?
I think that, come back me up on this. The main reason for this case study area was something like that. It's something that a complaint and dispute between the municipality and the local inhabitants of the area.
It's disputes because so of the setbacks set by the...
It's a decision, not disputes.
Yeah.
Decisions.
Disputes is about disputes.
Okay.
Okay?
It's fine, disputes. Don't get me wrong, it's not a dispute between municipalities
no,
and
no, no.
citizens. It's
the
just the public agency who set up the, who set the setbacks and the municipality with the local people against this.
Okay. The sixth is percentage of built areas within coastal zones per kilometer.
Less the better, on the other hand, more intensive the better, saving open space. So interesting, it's an interesting indicator.
Yeah.
Not just, all of these are not necessarily linear.
No, no, no. It has to do with conditions in each case. And money invested in public education and human resources on SSM issues. That's also something that an NGO will back up.
Sure.
By the way, can we go back?
Yeah.
My experience in trying to produce indicators for legislative issues, I want to make a distinction between inputs and outputs.
Mm-hmm.
I think that when an input serves as an indicator, we don't know what the output or the outcome will be. I would recommend rethinking the whole idea of using inputs. Because if the number of municipal and regional decision about coastal zone disputes, there are more, it doesn't mean that there is a
yeah.
So I think they should be translated as much as possible into outputs, not inputs.
Or separated from the
calendar. Or maybe you can raise a conclusion from the input and from the output.
But I personally need to think about it, not after lunch. I think that
everybody has to think of those indicators, even for tomorrow and the day after, because it's something that, as Raquel said, it's something we have to produce with numbers in order to have something visible in the project.
Oh, interesting curve of correlation.
Even that.
No, I mean, yes.
I just want to add at this stage the time factor. These indicators, of course, will continue after the project is finished.
Yes.
Because, of course, 2 years are not reasonable.
Yeah.
Right.
Talk here.
Everybody hear me?
No. Basically.
Yeah, I said the time factor. Because we're already 1 year into the project, we only have 2 years left. And of course, most of these indicators will keep on running after the project is finished, because it's not reasonable to really see results within 2 years. So we have to take that into consideration too.
You can propose the indicators also for self-assessment, but I'm sure they'll be much more sophisticated. They're a nice first launch.
So, number of elegant constructions on coastal areas. I think that's the better, there's no more the better. The percentage of areas registered in cadastral. Number of enforcement personnel on ICZM issues. That's a question mark. It's about more or less.
More.
You think more, but someone will say...
Number of enforcement personnel per infringements calibrated by infringements.
It's difficult.
Okay.
It's a cost benefit.
It's a cost benefit issue, yeah. It's also a cost benefit.
Here's one against all the NGOs. Go, shoot.
Okay. And the number of court action decisions on ICZM. That's. The one
we,
is
we would love to have less because the planning in the beginning would be great.
There is no such
thing. That's also something that I would like to hear the opinion of your boss. The years of effective monitoring of ISMM data, which has to do more or less about observatories and the observing the coastal areas. Is it something you feel it like something that is going to stand as an indicator? Because you said before that you have data from the station, the sea station, from 2000 until 2012. What about having data only from 2000 until 2006?
Yeah, but it's also the quality of the data and the,
yeah,
and the parameters.
Yes. But I wanted to, as I told right now, we wanted to go to a certain level first and then go deep against the indicator. If we have to produce an indicator, we also have other parameters or conditions, yes. Probably.
Yeah,
but it's difficult at this point of what package 5 in the second.
Probably number as well.
I would say the degree of effective monitoring.
Right.
Rather than the years.
Consistency, because you don't want to be there all the time.
No, that's not measurable. It's very hard to measure that.
Yeah.
It's something that you can measure.
Yeah, it's something that you can measure.
But here's the one monitoring to be there all the time in the future. You're not looking back. You're looking in the future. It's always going to be there. So it should be coverage or something like that. Or
so I will ask you, do you have data?
Of course, the monitoring.
Do you really have measurable data every year for your research?
It's very difficult.
It's very difficult. It's that's why.
Difficult because it's costier. Yeah. That's why.
That's why.
But you have ideas. Yes, but this is an indicator because ideally you should care.
You should have, yes.
In order to perform ISSM.
So
the fact that we don't care really doesn't mean anything. I mean, we should. Show that we are not performing well.
You know? So that's the case here. That these indicators indicate how you implement ISSM as you should, not as you can.
How would you quantify it?
Because the degree is not quantifiable.
Yeah. Well, for example, there is the Water Framework Directive or other directives, for example, for EU, which establish what set of parameters, how often, for how long you should monitor in an area, and what do you do with this data if you want to classify the system. So there are, I mean, you can.
I can include except for time and another parameters. You say if I'm
yes.
Understand correctly.
Time is not the most appropriate here.
Okay. So, go forward. Number 13. The number of transport operation projects on ISSM, like ours. And the 14th, the percentage of people in community that are happy with the kind of land uses. I think that's something that Jesse proposed in the books. I'm not sure.
Happy with lots of pubs and restaurants and discos, residential, whistling vans on the coast.
You don't know.
Happy NGOs.
But you put the board better, so okay. It's an indicator, but it's much, much more nuanced.
And it's something that it's also measurable.
You
do a survey and you know about it. Number of, and the last one is number of ISSM stakeholders participating in educational workshops. About prices.
Okay.
That's also right. About the prices. And we try to, let's say, create some of recommendations in order to discuss something about the toolkit also, like...
Can I say something before we...
Yeah, yeah.
About the... I think a good indicator also how much the media talks about. And how many
articles and meeting
meetings.
Okay. I should write it somewhere. But that's the point of the indicators. That's proposed indicators, and that's the point of it. As I have started in post, I want you to think of them and send me and Kostas whatever you think is a measurable indicator and it's not included, or or even say that this indicator is at a certain point it's too vague, and let's make it more detailed.
To be honest, and everybody, we are nearing the core of the project, which is the toolbox of alternative regulatory, financial, property, institutional instruments. I think it's premature now. I think
yeah,
this is a
it
very
is.
Good.
It is.
But so it's time to fine tune these is together. Once we start rolling with the instruments, come back to those rather than now. But I mean, yes.
I probably have showed you what we did in Volos, and you will see that much different and
no,
more
it's
vague
good.
Than now.
It's very good now. I think it's a good thing to get minds going, but then we need to apply it in relation to instruments in order that the indicators will relate.
But we also need to identify the instruments.
Oh yeah, that's
yeah, that's,
so,
that's something that's going to be done by toolkit, probably.
Yeah, yeah, the toolkit is
an instrument.
Yeah.
As a PPGIS instrument. So
PPGIS is...
It's for the public participatory procedures. It's a tool.
Yes.
So
it's a tool of a different kind.
Yes. Yeah.
It's a standalone...
Maybe yes, maybe no. Anna will tell us tomorrow. It's more like steps. I don't know if it will help Rachel or you for the toolkit. It's like 8 steps starting with the development of a common conceptual framework with the EU-ICLM implementations. Raise the profile of ICLM locally, because I'm talking about the local level here, and also awareness, guidance, training, education, enhance stakeholders' coordination and participation, incorporate ICLM in all relevant programs and instruments, planning, specific planning, environmental planning, establish monitoring and data collection, improve the knowledge basis of all ICLM, and establish transborder territorial cooperation when it's So it's more of a 8 steps for a guide, and maybe this could help start up a framework for the toolkit. So that's all about it.
Questions,
thoughts,
comments, remarks,
disputes.
That would be forward. It's a nice way.